want to open the floor with questions to begin with, so if you guys have some questions, please shout them out.
Austin, my name's Tom with Rock Titan. Boston is renowned for its amazing musicianship and guitar work. Are there any bands that you see today that can get to that level, in your opinion?
Any
bands that you see out there today that have Boston's kind of musicianship, because it's on such a high level?
You know, it's funny that you mentioned that part of it. To me, all bands have great musicianship, but they don't necessarily use it in the same way. And, you know, it's intentional, I'm assuming. But in fact, we were on tour with the Doobie Brothers once, and Pat Simmons came up and said, "How do you guys remember all those notes?" It's like, well, you just do, you know, that's what our thing is. But it's like Bob Dylan, you wouldn't say he was a great singer per se. He doesn't sound like Pavarotti. What he does with his voice is so special. So that's the way I look at other bands too. It's like, yeah, maybe they're not the fastest player, and neither am I, but what they do with the, you know, with two notes can be fantastic.
Thank you.
Generic question, but what's your favorite restaurant in New York City?
Well, what I'm gonna eat at tonight. I don't know what it's going to be.
Well, in the past, though, from years of coming here, do you have a favorite?
Of restaurants?
Yeah.
In New York?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. You know, a long time ago, I don't know if it's still there, a friend took me to John's Pizza Parlor. Mm-hmm. Is it still there? The coal fire pizza?
It's still there.
That was excellent. That may be the one I go to tonight.
Cool. Thank you.
Is it still a thrill to tour?
Absolutely. People ask me, it's like, well, do you get tired of playing the same songs after 40 years? It's like, well, I would if I had to sit in my living room and do it. When you stand on stage, you look out in the audience, and people are smiling and singing along, sometimes louder than the band. And I tell you, I get choked up sometimes. Like, more than a feeling. It's like, it's just the best feeling ever. I'm so lucky to be able to do it.
Has your perception changed a little bit now when you're on the stage? Seeing all these iPhones in the air and seeing that light shine, how do you feel about that?
You know, that's funny you mentioned that. Yeah, in the old days, there'd be cigarette lighters, you know? And now you look out and it's full of glowing. It's like, well, the signs there are changing. It's a thrill, especially in a song like Amanda, which was technically was the only number one song that Boston has ever had. More Than a Feeling and Rockin' My Band, almost only made it to number two because Stevie Wonder always had number one. So we play Amanda and people are like, you know, their iPhones rapping.
Yeah.
So it's great. And we've met a lot of girls named Amanda over the years.
Oh, I'm sure. Who's
named for that song?
I'm sure. Who was the inspiration behind that song?
Tom said that it was really a combination of several people. So not just one of them. And same with some of the other songs, like Holly Ann and Mary. It's not just one girl.
Is there another studio album in the works?
Tom and the rest of us are always working on new musical ideas. In fact, we're even going to be playing some new material, some new songs, well, some new music, I should say, here on tour this summer. So that's stuff that people have never heard before. So, again, we're always thinking of new stuff.
Cool.
It can be anything. It can be like a guitar riff, or it's that's just a cool riff. I just love playing the way that sounds. You know? Or it could be an idea, some thematic sort of thing. Again, a social issue or a relationship issue. It's just like whatever strikes your fancy.
And do you anticipate any pre-show ritual with Joan?
Joan, I understand that she really loves rock and roll. And she's not afraid of her bad reputation. So
you make jokes!
So, looking forward to it. I've never done a gig with Jessica. She's been on some of the festivals with us. But we play one day and she's on the next one. So I'm on hold with her. And she's a vegetarian, like Tom and I are too. So we have something in common over there.
Do you guys share snacks ever behind the scenes?
Absolutely, yeah.
What's your second choice?
Snack of choice. Oh, gosh. There's so much. We travel with an old chef, and She makes stuff that I don't even know what it is, but it tastes great. So I guess I can't even tell her.
And how do you like sharing the stage with someone else that is just you guys?
Oh, yeah, it's an honor to be part of a show like that. And again, the audience is different than when we do a show on our own. It's great. They're obviously just all Boston fans. But when you play for other bands, there's like a Cheap Trick and Sticks and all that. And it's great because they bring a different dynamic. You know, sometimes they're not always convinced that they like Boston as much as any of the other bands. You know, it's like, oh, we're here to see them. But they stick around and they seem to like those two.
So Tom is known to be a perfectionist in the studio. Is it the same way with the live show, or is it more of a democracy?
Yeah, he's always a perfectionist, yeah. But what musician isn't? You know, it's like we all sit in our bedroom or in the basement or whatever and practice as much as possible. So that's not different from him or anybody else. But we certainly do work at it. And of course, you know, when they put together those lists of 100 greatest guitar players of all time, Tom's always on there. But he's also on the list of 100 greatest keyboard players of all time. There's nobody else in the world that's on both those lists. And then the fact that he designed the amplifiers that were using on stage,
right.
And of course, you know, all the songs that he's written. So he's a really special guy. It's great being working with him.
Scott Johnson, Rock Titan TV again. Just real curious, because a band as iconic as Boston, you've got the kind of sound that would radiate through a crowd of a million people easily. Do you have a personal preference, indoor venues versus outdoor venues?
No, everyone is different.
Yeah. And, so do you have a favorite? Best outdoor, best indoor?
No, I can't say I do.
No?
You know?
Okay.
And sometimes it's the craziest show that turns out to be the best. You know, like,
all right.
You know, it'll be raining thunder, you know, and we're playing and it's like rain coming in or something, you know. And that'll be like, wow, well, that was a great night. You know?
Right, nice.
And we hear that from our fans, too, that they'd say, well, we weren't sure it was going to rain. We were driving there. We got a flat tire on the way. You know, but we finally made it. We got there just in time. And they say, you know, that was the most memorable night we, you know, we've had ever.
Nice.
So that's nice to hear.
That's very cool. Thank you.
You mentioned the iPhones instead of cigarette lamps. Do you find people these days, audiences, are they more distracted?
Distracted by, you know, when they are sort of wearing their iPhones, do you feel there's a distraction there?
I think the old days with the lighters were more distracting, like, whoa, look out with that thing.
So, I mean, people themselves using their phones, is it a distraction for you?
You know, it's a matter of fact, sometimes we'll look down the audience and see people like texting and this and that. They think, well, are they paying attention or is it just that they want to share it? So it's kind of a blurred line. So, yeah, but again, you know, we've seen people in the audience like they're feeling down. Listen to this. This is great. You know, it's like they want to share it with the fans. So how can you complain about that?
Is Michael Sweet on this tour?
No, he's not. He's out with this other band, Stryker. So we have Tommy DiCarlo.
He's great.
Back with us, and he's great. You know, of course, he was never in a band before in his life. So we called him up. You know, somebody had seen some of his videos. He loved the band and loved the music, and would just record his versions of our songs. And so we called him up one day and said, "Hey, you know, this is Boston. We want you to come audition for us." And he said, "Bobby, is this you? Who is this really?" He's like, "No, really, this is Boston."
Before Journey did that.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So never been in a band before in his life, and he's great. What a wonderful guy.
And on the topic of summer concerts, what has been your favorite summer concert memory, whether it's something that you perform or watching as a kid?
You know, I gotta say, I've been to a lot of summer concerts, yeah. Both as a performer and as an audience member. And there's just so many great ones, and they're all so different. I'll have to say one of the highlights of my life as a performer was the Texas Jam in '87. It was my first tour in Boston. And we were supposed to have about a half a dozen warm-up shows before the Texas Jam. It was in Texas Stadium there, and the Cotton Bowl, 84,000 people. And, but we were having trouble with equipment, because again, it was all stuff that Tom had designed and engineered, and we were trying to get it all working correctly to make it sound just like the album. So we only had one Walmart show before that, and then here we are in front of 84,000 people. And a lot of lighters that
yeah.
night. So that was a big, big moment.
So you remember your first tour pretty well?
First tour with Boston? Oh, absolutely. Yeah. But even before I was in the band, I was playing the same behavior for 8 years. And almost one of the first things we did was open up for Boston at the end of their first tour in 1977. And then they liked us, we liked them, so they asked us to do the whole second tour, which we did 78 through 79. And then in 85, when Sandy got the call to join Van Halen, Tom Scholz from Boston called me and said, hey, I heard you're out of the gig. Why don't you come back here and help me finish the third stage album? And I've been here ever since.
Things happen for a reason.
Yeah. So I left from my last gig with Sandy, which was Farming War in Champaign, Illinois, and flew directly from there to Boston to start working with Tom. But, how lucky can a guy get? You know, he wasn't out of work for a day.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you, Gary. It's so nice to meet you.
Thank you.